This is Bob Kraft of TennisMinistry.org. I'm here talking about players I've had contact with for a number of years. Some of the names you'll know and some you won't, unless you're very, you know, involved in a particular country. You might not know some of these names. One is Yan Zi. Yan Zi is the top doubles player in China. She has been for a number of years, and I'm going to share a little bit about how I've gotten to know her, how I've been able to reach out to her with the gospel message of Jesus Christ. She was one of the first Chinese players I met when I was traveling full-time on the Pro Tour back in the early 2000s. She's been always a doubles player, hasn't really been able to compete in singles, but she didn't have the power really to compete, but she's incredibly quick with her reflexes. She's got incredible double shots, and I've been able to spend time with her. She spoke English, which was the first Chinese player who could speak English very well. And she's always been very kind to me. So from the very beginning, I gave her material, Christian material, tracts. I gave her a Bible. She's always accepted it. And I've been very fortunate to be able to spend time with her. Plus, she's played doubles with players that I've worked very closely with, like Mark Knowles has been one of her consistent mixed doubles partners. So she's been in the finals of Grand Slams. Mark is a committed believer. And so I've been able to sit in the player's box while she's been playing in finals. Now, she is someone who I didn't really know the impact I had on her spiritually until last October when I was at the Beijing Open in China in the year 2010. And I was run into her and I was talking to her and speaking to her. And she was sitting with someone next to me, and she was speaking in Chinese, and I could pick up enough of the words to get the general idea of the conversation. And basically what she was saying was that I had given her some material tracks, written material in the years past, and she still carried it with her in her bag, and it meant a lot to her. And I stopped her in mid-conversation and I started speaking to her in English because she speaks such good English. And I told her what I heard her saying, and she said, yes, that's right. And she went on and told me she appreciated that I gave that to her, and she still read it, and it meant a lot to her. And I said to her, well, would you like some more? And she said, yes, I would like you to give me some more. And she lives in Hong Kong now, which is my hometown. And even though I don't have close contact with her because she's traveling and I don't see her frequently, I promised her I'd get her more material. And I couldn't bring it. I saw when I spoke to her prior at the Australian Open about giving her some material, I told her I would give it to her in mainland China, in Beijing. But actually, I couldn't get it in across the border because spiritual Christian material is not really that welcome through the immigration customs. And I couldn't bring it in, and I explained that to her, and she said, yes, I know that. So she chose to live in Hong Kong, where we have freedom of information and press here, and I told her I would try to source it, and to this day I'm still trying to hook up to give her material. So do pray for her as she has a desire to grow spiritually in Christ, and that's Yan Zi.